Hey there folks, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's investment banking tutorial, and today's topic is average collection period. So the average collection period is the amount of time which the company typically takes to receive payment from its debtors. So for example, if I sold a particular for a particular period, let's just say my sales was XYZ numbers, and average receivables for that period is again XYZ numbers. So if I divide the average receivables by the overall sales times it by the number of days in a period, then I would arrive at the average collection period. Now we will get back to the computation in a while, but let's just look at the data here and also, you know, what it entails. Alright, so the formula for the average collection period is, like I said, average accounts receivable per day, you know, at the average credit sales. Or maybe you can just take the credit sales for that particular period. So if you're working for, if you want to calculate it for a quarter, then it would be 90 days. But if you want to do it for the whole year, then it's going to be 365 days. All right. So with that being said, let's just look at the example here. And the example which says a company decides to increase its credit term, the top management of the company requests the accountant to find out the collection period of the company in current scenario. Alright, so here's a scenario which is given, and you can just go ahead and read it and, you know, understand, you know, how the company can use this information to, you know, negotiate its terms. Alright. Yeah, so before we jump into the computation, let's look at the calculation for the average collection period here. And if you look at the values which are given here to the accountant, you know, it says that the net credit sales for the year was $150,000, and accounts receivable at the beginning was this much, and receivables at the end was $30,000. So this gives an average accounts receivable of $25,000, and then this particular value can be plugged in to ascertain the accounts receivable turnover ratio. So the ratio would be net credit sales by the average accounts receivable, which was $25,000, which we just saw. Okay, so now this gives us a ratio of 6.6 times basically. And this ratio divided by the overall, the number of days divided by this ratio gives us the average collection period, which is 61 days in this example. Now, let's just also look at the uses for average collection period. So, the first use would be to ascertain how much time does the company takes to get its money back. And you know, this is a very vital information in terms of cash flows. Alright, so if you know that it takes me 40 days on an average to collect my money back, you can, you know, negotiate the terms of credit with your suppliers. Alright, obviously they have to agree to that, but then if they agree, you know, then you can manage the working capital in such a fashion. Alright, then the second use would be, you know, it also helps the company to, you know, decide if any efficient way of collecting cash can be devised, you know, based upon this particular information. All right so now let's just look at a live example for a company, and then we can wrap this up. All right so let's go to Edgar, and we will look at, let's look at Walmart. Alright, so Walmart, oops, so maybe there's nothing here. I think it is just Wal, not double L, it's just Mart, Walmart. Yeah, Walmart Inc. So it's here, and we will download the 10K, which is the annual report, and look at the data there. All right. So now coming back here, you have to go to Exhibits, or so yeah, selected financial data. So here you see the value for 2018. So this is the year ended Jan 31st, 2018. So this particular value was for basically the period starting from 1st Feb 2017 till 31st Jan 2018. So the total revenues for this particular period has been to the tune of $500 billion. Yeah, so the amount is in millions, and this is $500 billion. And let's just also look at the income statement, if it is given here. Yeah, so again the same information is given here. So we have the information for 16, 17 and 18 respectively here, and here it was for the last 5 years. Alright, so we can come down here and take the value for the last 3 years, and that would probably give us a sneak peek in the collection period for this particular company. Alright, so let me just open Excel. So the values are total revenue, so we have the value for total revenue for the year 18, 17 and 16. Now what we want is the average value for accounts receivable. So accounts receivable at the start of the year and at the end of the year. So let's just go down here. Yeah, so receivables, the data for receivables for 18 and 17 is this much. So it is 5 billion and 5.8 billion and 6 billion, but we don't have the value for 16 and 15. So let me also find it with this particular word here. Receivables. Alright, so as we don't have the data, we'll have to go back and, you know, download the sheets for the previous years. But then let's just, you know, do this for just a single year. So with this particular data, we will be able to do the average collection period for 2017, right, like 2018, you know. So receivables net. So 2017 is this value and 2018 is 6756. Alright, so average value average receivables is going to be what? Average receivables is going to be an average of these two numbers, Alright, so this is average receivables, and we have the value for total revenues. Now we just have to do the math. So average collection period is going to be average receivables by total revenue times 365, that is the number of days in the period. So the average collection period comes out to be 5 days, and you know, this is a pretty good number. So it just means that it takes company just 5 days to, you know, recover the money from credit sales, and this is a good number, you know. So on similar terms, you can do the average collection period for the past 3-4 years, and then you can, you know, maybe plot them in the graph and ascertain the trend. So if it is, you know, decreasing, then the company is doing good, and if it is increasing, you know, then the company is doing relatively good. All right, but then the numbers have to be in this range, you know. So typically a company having an average collection period of 30 days is good. And in this case, if we see that the company is having an average collection period of 5 days, you know, this number would be rounded off, because, you know, you cannot have days in points, you know. So then that means it's a good thing. Alright, so let's just go back to the website and try to relook at the formula once again. So average collection period, you know, here, you know, a different computation is being used, so which is given here, so which is what we have seen. Alright, and you can also do it in this way, or you can also do it in this way, you know, the numbers would be just the same. So we can probably do it in this way as well. And so the average collection period here, it says that, you know, it is 365 days by the accounts receivable turnover ratio, and accounts receivable turnover ratio is nothing but the sales upon the average accounts receivable. All right, so if we do it in this way, it is going to be the overall sales by the average receivables. So this is going to be accounts receivables turnover ratio and if we divide 365 by this value, then that should give us the average collection period. So again, with this formula, the average collection period is going to be 365 by this value, which is 4.96. So basically there are two ways of doing it, you know, you can use any of the ways, but the answer is going to be the same. All right. So I hope you've had fun watching this, and bye for now.